Hey guys, so I'm still working on those raid guides, those are going to be up soon, but for now I want to at least show you guys the locations of the calcified fragments and the chests in the King's Fall raid. We're going to be going in order of the things appearing in the raid. So the first chest is after the hive ship jumping puzzle. It's at the part where you need two people to hold the plates in order to cross through to the other side. Before you're about to pass through the threshold, instead, jump off to the left and go all the way up the ramp. When you get to basically the top, look to your right and there should be a doorway. Note that two people need to be on those plates for the door to be open, otherwise it will stay closed. Hop up and in front of you will be chest number one. The first fragment is right before the teleporter up to the first encounter. You're going to see the teleporter that shoots you up, but do not go in it just yet. Instead, look on the pillar that blocked your view of said teleporter, and on the right corner will be the first fragment. Head up the teleporter now, and when you get to the Prove Your Worth encounter, you'll see a fragment pretty easily on your right next to the pillar. That's the freebie. After the War Priest encounter, you'll enter Golgoroth's cellar. There is a fragment and a chest here. Let's grab the fragment first. At the first intersection, make a left, then at the next intersection, make another left. You should be in a pretty small dead-end area, but you can jump up to find the next fragment.
Super Bowl's not going to be in Roman numerals this year.
What?
Why wouldn't it be?
Because it's 50, so I guess they thought L was boring, so they're going with just 5-0.
Super Bowl L.
Oh, there's a fragment.
Fragment!
Chest number two is a bit crazy, and I must give all credit to my clanmate Helljumper for figuring this out at the time. In this maze are four hidden plates. You must step on these plates in the right order. But first, you need to find the plates because you won't even notice them if you aren't paying attention. They also don't light up when you stand on them. The first plate is near the fragment that we just picked up. The second is going to be on the opposite side, so instead of going left at the entrance, go right. Then when you hit the intersection, go right and you'll see a plate on the floor. The third plate is even more hidden. From the entrance, make a right, then a left, and then go all the way down. Use your ghost to scan the area above the big door. You'll see a little hole. You need to get into that doorway by jumping on rocks and pillars, going through the door, and jumping down onto the other side. The final plate is back the other direction. From where you started jumping to get into the third plate room, walk, then make a left, then a right, then another right. You'll see a big rock wall that seems to block your path, just jump over it, and that's the fourth plate. Plate number three goes first, the hidden doorway one. You're gonna hear a very loud noise, that's fine. The next plate is the second plate that we covered. Again, it will make a noise, but it should only make one noise. If it makes a lot of noise, you messed it up, so try it again. After two, it's one, then four, so the order is 3, 2, 1, 4. When done correctly, the doors will open and you can get the chest. The chest is in the center of the maze. If you were in the hidden doorway, it'll open, make a right, then another right, and you'll see the chest. It's in the dead center. Let's move on. After Golgoroth, start walking to the next area. Walk around the big rock in the first room, then in the second room, make a left. As soon as you walk through the doorway, there will be a ledge on your left that you can jump on. The next fragment is on that ledge. Next, you'll reach another platforming puzzle with giant spikes coming out of the walls. The next fragment is at the start of this. Jump down to the lowest platform that you can, and the fragment will be in the corner on the lowest platform. The last chest that we know of is after you jump across to the opposite side. When you get to the second plate, take out your ghost and look for some hidden platforms. You're going to steadily make your way up. Just follow what we do on the screen to climb to the top. You'll hit a doorway, head inside, and get your chest.
Guardian down.
Guardian down. Guardian down.
If you're super pro, you can use the spikes on the opposite side wall to launch yourself into the doorway here and can ignore all the platforming. No, this is not the real way to get in, but man, is it way better. Those are the fragment and chest locations for the King's Fall raid, at least that we know of. If anything else is discovered, I will update the description of this video with information on how you can find anything new. Thank you all very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.